Hello and welcome you all in this video tutorial. This video is for class 9th, chapter number 1, Computer System, part 1. Before starting this chapter, dear student, I want to tell you, do not go anywhere else. Stay at your home. Take all the precautions. Wash your hand. Use sanitizer. Take healthy food and focus on your study. Now, by this video tutorial, I am going to discuss computer application, in that the chapter number 1, Computer System, part 1. Now, we are going to start. Now, in this chapter, dear student, the contents that we are going to discuss is, the first one is characteristics of a computer. So before discussing about the content, let me tell you what is a computer. So dear students, as you already know, a computer is an electronic machine or a device through which we can perform multiple tasks at the same time. Or how you will define computer? A computer is an electronic machine which receives input. According to the input, it generates responsive output. Responsive means, according to the input, your output is always accurate. So that is why I am telling you, it is an electronic machine which receives input. According to the given input, it produces a responsive output. Next thing that we discuss, the contents, topics which we are going to discuss, cover in this particular chapter. The first one is characteristics of a computer. In this, we are going through about what are the strengths of a computer that we have. Next is limitation of a computer, applications of a computer, hardware, software, functions of a computer, at last CPU and its components. So first, let me discuss about characteristics of a computer. Just go through this, characteristics of a computer. In characteristics, first let me discuss about the strength of a computer. If we discuss about the strength of a computer, though we are having so many strengths, like the first one is speed. As you know, a computer works at an amazing speed without making any mistake. A normal person would complete a specific task in few hours, whereas the same task is finished by a computer within a fraction of a second. Calculation can be done in milliseconds. The speed of a computer is measured in millisecond or nanosecond. So just assume, just think how much fast processing your computer is having. Due to this much speed, your computer can deal with multiple processes at the same time. That is why we can say our computer is a multitasking and it is a multiprocessing also. Next strength that we have is accuracy. In addition to speed, a computer performs its task with great accuracy. What it means, great accuracy? Great accuracy means it hardly commits mistakes in the processing of data. That mistakes or error generally occurs when the input is inaccurate or the hardware is not functioning properly. Only these two cases, your computer may generate wrong result. Apart from this, your computer will produce 100% accurate result. For example, if you provide as an input 2 plus 2, so always as an output you will get 4 only. You never have seen you provided input 2 plus 2 and output you are getting 6. So that is why at the beginning only I told, a computer is an electronic machine, it receives input. According to the input, it processes and generates a responsive output. This is a major strength of a computer, that is accuracy. The third strength that we have is reliability. A computer is more reliable than human being, as it never gets tired by doing the repetitive task. It can operate for long hours without taking rest, with its accuracy intact. For example, as a human being, we are not reliable than computer. Why? Because if we have to do a repetitive task for long hour, so as a human being, we get tired or we get bored. But our machine never gets bored for doing the repetitive task. For example, ATM machines computer. If you have ever visited on any ATM machine, so you might have seen that particular computer works 24/7 and it will perform the repetitive task. Then also it will never get tired or bored. So computer is more reliable than human being. This is the third strength that given in your book. Moving to the next one, storage capacity. A computer can store large amount of data in its memory. And that stored data you may access after a day, after a month, or after a year. If we compare this storage capacity to human being not stored, only stored the frequent data. Rest all, human being may he or she will forget. For example, dear students, if I ask you, have you remember whatever you studied in your previous class? So might your answer is no. Because it is the human nature. We don't have much storage capacity comparing than computer. Computer can store large amount of data, and that data is reusable for any time. Whenever you required, you can access that data. But as a human being, we stored only frequent data. Rest all we can forget. We will forget. Next, strength, versatility. A computer can perform various types of jobs. Various types of jobs simultaneously. Like, if someone wants to listen music while typing on MS Word, then both the works he can perform, he can do on a computer simultaneously. That is why we can say that our computer is a multitasking. It can deal with multiple tasks at the same time. Why these all things will happen? Because our processor speed is that much. It can deal with multiple process, multiple tasks at the same time. Due to the speed, as a human being, we are not able to recognize. So our computer is more versatile than human. Next, if we have so many advantages, apart from this, we have many more strength, like reduction in manpower, reduction in paperwork. Reduction in paperwork means with the help of computer, a large amount of paper wastage can be prevented in any organization. For example, a computer stores data in the form of record with the help of reducing a lots of paperwork. For example, record of a student in a school can be stored on a computer rather than keeping it manual files for each individuals. Dear student, just think, if in a school, if there is a 2000, there are 2000 students, and if we keep all the records manually, so we need 2000 papers. In place of this, if we use computer, then computer manage all the data without wasting that much papers. So this is also called a strength of a computer, reduction in a paperwork. Now we have discussed so many advantages, strengths, characteristics. Along with this, computer having some disadvantages also, some limitations also, some demerits also. The first demerits that we have is limited ability to think. A computer still have no intelligence to take decision by its own. That is one. Now, applications of a computer. Before that, we have discussed the limitation of a computer, like it totally depend on power, not able to take decision by its own. So likewise, we have some demerits and disadvantages. Next point that we have to discuss is application of a computer. Application means, what do you mean by application? Means at what field, at what place we are using computer, that is the applications. Like as in your books given, military. In military, we use computer for designing and operating high-tech weapons. In banks, nowadays it is possible only because of computer to make online transactions, checking balance, transferring amount one account to another account, for paying any bill like telephone bill, electricity bill, water bill, doing purchasing any products through online transactions. So these all things are possible because of the application of computer that we are using in the field of banks. Along with this, we have some application of computer in education field also. Like for example, if you want to search any topic, so easily by using computer you can search that particular topic on internet. You are allowed to access the services of e-learning. As a student, you can attend online classes, you can schedule your timetables. So these all things are possible because of computer that we are using in the field of education. Likewise, we have some application in media and communication also. We use computer in businesses also, engineering and manufacturing, in our daily lives, in criminal identification and law enforcement, government sectors, sports, media and communications. We use computer in medical science also. We use computer in library and museum, mobile computing, publishing, computer in daily life. So likewise, so many fields are there where we use computer. So computer plays a important role to enhance the process of digitalizations. In short, we can say that nowadays we are using computer in almost all fields. As we discuss the applications of a computer, so likewise, some of applications I mentioned here. Apart from this, we have many more applications of computer in various fields. Okay, moving to the next point. Hardware and software. Dear student, first let me tell you about what is hardware. Hardware refers all the physical component of a computer system. It includes all input devices, processing devices, storage devices, and output devices. As you can see the first line, hardware refers to all physical component of a computer system. Physical component like input devices, keyboard, mouse, scanner, processing devices, central processing unit, CPU, motherboard, storage devices, hard disk, pen drive, CD drive, floppy disk, output devices like monitor, printer, projector. So likewise, whatever physical components of a computer system that we are using, that all comes under hardware. And as you know, hardware having real world existence. So that is why here I mention all the physical component of a computer known as a computer's hardware. And that hardware may include all the input devices, processing devices, storage devices, as well as output devices. Next point, software. Software, as you know, it is a set of programs which control all the internal and external operation of a computer. As I mentioned here, a software is a set of programs which controls the internal operation of a computer and instruct computer what to do. Dear student, as you know, and it is common also, as you know, if a hardware is there, then hardware not able to work by its own. The same way, our computer hardware needs instruction to work. So the main role of software is to control the internal operation and instruct computer what to do. Instruct the hardware what to do. It means through the hardware we provide some input to our computer, and through software computer will process that particular input, and after processing it will instruct computer what kind of output users want. The software is a set of program, and what is a program? Program are the set of instructions which controls the internal operation of a computer and instruct computer what to do. Because every time computer hardware need instruction to work, and that instruction is given by the software. Because as you know, as a human being we understood high level language, and our machine, our electronic circuit will understood only 0 and 1 binary digits. So to establish communication between both the ends we need some set of programs, and that set of programs are known as software. So don't forget the basic organization of a computer system, that may consist hardware and software. So hardware, just now we discussed all the physical components, software set of program which control all the internal operation and instruct computer what to do. Moving to the next, functions of a computer. Dear student, if we discuss about the function of a computer, so computer first it required input. After input it processed the data, given input data. After processing, if required, then it stored the data. At last you will get the output. So likewise in your book as given four function of a computer: input, process, storage and output. And through diagram also I try to explain. First you will provide input 2+2, then this particular input will processed. After processing, if required, it will store that particular processing data, and then after it will give the responsive output, that is 4. So likewise your computer will functions in four different processes, like input, processing, storage and output. The first we are going to discuss is input unit. A computer accepts the input given by the user. It can be in the form of instructions or data. Instructions are given to the computer to operate on the data. It means, as I told you, your computer hardware needs instruction. So instruction always we provide with the help of input units, and that input unit is a interface to give input to our computer, and that input may be instruction or data. Next, central processing unit. Central processing unit process the converting data into meaningful information according to the user's instruction is called processing. Output unit, the final result or output available to the user either on the monitor, soft copy or as printout is known as output or hard copy. Okay. Now dear student, next topic that we are going to discuss is CPU and its component. Now before this we discussed the basic organization of a computer, that is input unit, central processing unit and output unit. Input unit, through which we provide some input to our computer. Processing unit, which consider the input and process according to the input. And output unit, after final processing we get the output in the form of human and or in the form in human understandable format. Next topic that we have is CPU and its component. There are mainly three components of a CPU. First one is memory unit, that is MU. These all three components are the part of a CPU only. First we will discuss about memory unit, then second component is ALU, arithmetic and logical unit, and last one is control unit. The first component that we have is memory unit. Memory unit is the principal storage of a computer, is stored both data and instruction. I hope this you already know. Computer memory classified in two categories, internal and external memory. Internal memory, also known as primary memory or main memory. External memory, also known as auxiliary memory or secondary memory. So do not forget, dear student, memory classification in two categories, internal memory, primary memory or main memory, external memory, auxiliary memory or secondary memory. So first let me discuss about the internal memory. Internal memory, as you know, dear student, internal memory further classified in two categories, that is RAM and ROM. RAM, by name it is clear, random access memory. Random access memory, it is stored data temporarily. It means whatever work we are doing on a computer, that all happens on a RAM only. That is why I told you RAM is a main memory of your computer and it is a volatile memory. Volatile memory means as the power supply is on, all the data are stored. If once power supply is suspended, all the data are deleted permanently. So RAM is a primary memory, it is a volatile memory, and one more internal or primary memory that we have is ROM, read-only memory. But read-only memory is a non-volatile memory. RAM having some type as given in your book. First type, dynamic random access memory, static random access memory, synchronous dynamic random access memory, and last one is double data rate memory. Likewise, we have some type of ROM also, like PROM, EPROM, double EPROM, flash memory and mass ROM. Next, if we discuss about secondary memory, whatever secondary storage we are having, that all are non-volatile. Like hard disk stored information permanently. It means it not depend on power. Here the two points you have to understand, volatile and non-volatile. Volatile memories are those memory which store data temporarily. Non-volatile memories are those memory which store data permanently. External memory, all the external memory are non-volatile, like hard disk, pen drive, floppy, CD, DVD, mass ROM or flash memory. These all storage devices store information permanently. It not depend on power. If you once save your data, your save data stored for long time use. Whereas if we talk about internal memory, nothing but RAM, the RAM stored information temporarily. It means it totally depend on power. Till the time power supply is on, information is remain as it is. Once power supply is suspended, information has gone or deleted permanently. So I think it is clear to everyone, memory classification in two types, two categories, internal and external. Internal memory, also known as primary memory or main memory. External, secondary memory or auxiliary memory. Do not forget. Next component of CPU that we have is ALU, arithmetic and logical unit. Dear student, arithmetical and logical unit of a CPU responsible to control all the arithmetical as well as logical operations. Arithmetical means it perform all the arithmetic calculation like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Logical means it perform greater than, less than, greater than, equal to, not equal to, equal to. So this component ALU is responsible to deal with both arithmetical as well as logical operations. Arithmetical, addition, subtraction, multiplication. Logical means equal to, not equal to, less than, greater than or equals to. At last we have control unit. This unit controls the operations of every components of a computer system. It also controls the transfer of data and instruction among various units of a computer. It means overall controlling happen through this particular control unit. It control overall, it monitor overall data transfer of data or passes the instruction among various units. So overall management is done with this control unit. One diagram is also given in your book, figure number 1.2. Using the by seeing that figure, you may understood these three component, that is control unit, ALU and MU. Okay, so likewise in this session, in this video session, only this much question, few questions I have mentioned here. After seeing the video, try to solve this question. Write four characteristics and limitation of a computer. At the starting of the slide, the video, we have discussed brief explanation of application of computer in the field of banking and education. This also we have discussed. What are the difference between RAM and ROM? That just now I told. RAM, whatever RAM, random access memory we are having, that all are volatile. ROM, non-volatile. RAM stands for random access memory, ROM stands for read-only memory. RAM having 4 type, ROM having 6 type, 5 types. So likewise, some difference we are having. What is the need of secondary memory? So as you know, secondary memory we need to use to store information or data permanently. Write functions of a computer. Functions, just now I told you, input, process, storage and output. So try to analyze yourself by seeing this video and try to solve this question. As I already told some answers, so don't worry. Then also, please analyze yourself. Thank you, everyone.